वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू महिला समाज ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। दिस इज द कंटिन्यूएशन क्लास ऑफ बॉडी मूवमेंट्स सेशन नंबर 2। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन टू बॉडी मूवमेंट्स, बॉल एंड सॉकेट जॉइंट्स, पिवोटल जॉइंट, हिंग जॉइंट। इन टुडेज क्लास we will discuss the remaining concepts. Okay children, the first concept is fixed joints. Some joints between in our head are different and cannot move. Such joints are called as fixed joints. Once again I will repeat, observe carefully children. Some joints between in our head are different and cannot move. Such joints are called as fixed joints. When we open our mouth wide, we can move lower jaw but not upper jaw. Once again I will repeat, observe carefully. When we open our mouth wide, we can move lower jaw but not upper jaw, because there is a joint between upper jaw and head which is a fixed joint. Understood? Observe the picture. Children, all the bones in our body form a framework to give a shape to our body. This framework is called as skeleton. Once again I will repeat, all the bones in our body form a framework to give a shape to our body. This framework is called as skeleton. The human skeleton is composed of around 305 bones at birth. The number of bones in the skeleton changes with age. It decreases to 206 by adulthood after some bones are joined together. Children, observe the picture. How do we know that this is the shape of a human skeleton? How do we know the shapes of the different bones in our body? Children, one way we could know this shape better would be to look at x-ray images of the human body. Did you or anyone in your family ever have an x-ray of any part of your body taken? Children, so that when we are hurt or have an accident, doctors use x-rays images to find out about any possible injuries that might have happened to bones. Therefore, the x-ray helps to study the shapes and conditions of the bones in our body. We can feel the bones in our body at upper arm, lower arm, lower leg, upper leg or knee joints. Bend your fingers. It is so flexible to bend your fingers. Is it right? So, bones in the hand are made up of several small bones, are called as corpels. Children, take a deep breath and hold it for a little while. Feel your chest bones and the backbone by gently pressing the middle of the chest and back at the same time. So, we can observe the several ribs bent in our chest. They join the chest bone and the backbone together to form a box. This is called rib cage. What do you call that? Rib cage. There are 12 ribs on each side of the chest. Observe the below given rib cage image. Children, starting from the neck, move your fingers downwards on the back of your body you can feel it and it is a backbone. Correct? Backbone is made up of many small bones called vertebrate. Once again, I will repeat. Backbone is made up of many small bones called as vertebrate. The backbone consists of 33 vertebrate. The rib cage is joined to these bones. If backbone was made up of only one long bone, will your friend be able to bend? No. Make your friend stand with both hands pressed to the wall and ask her to push the wall. You will notice two bones on the backbone of your shoulders. They are called as shoulder bones. Children, the skull is made up of many bones joined together. It protects a very important part of the body, that is brain. We discussed many bones and the joints of our skeleton. Children, observe the picture. Children, there are some additional parts of the skeleton that are not as odd as the bones and which can be bent. These are called as cartilage. Children, feel your ear. It consists a soft bone and can be bent easily. Therefore, it is understood that upper part of ear has cartilage. That means the upper part of the ear is made up of cartilage. Cartilage is also found in the joints of the body. Children, we have seen that our skeleton is made up of many bones, joints and cartilage. You could feel, bend and move many of them. We have learned about the bones in our body and about joints that help us move in the different ways. What makes the bones move the way they do? Let us find out. Make a fist with one hand, bend your arm at the elbow and touch your shoulder with the thumb. You can observe a swollen region in the upper arm. This is called as muscle. Due to contraction and the muscle become swollen. Now bring your arm back to its normal position. What happened to the muscle? Is it still contract? You can observe similar contraction of muscles in your leg when you walk or run. When contracted, the muscles becomes shorter, stiffer and thicker. It pulls the bones. Children, observe the pictures. By this, we can understand that two muscles work together to move a bone. Children, by this, we have completed this session number 2. Now, note down the home assignment. Answer the following questions. First question, what is cartilage? Second question, how many bones does our body consist? Third question, what is fixed joint? Thank you. We will join in the next class.